Hello everyone, welcome to Andy Visits. In today's video, we'll be discussing some of the best, scariest movies of all time.
Here's Johnny!
The scariest movies of all time. These movies put characters through the worst day of their lives. Even if they survive, they are irrevocably changed. What menaces these heroes? Pretty much everything. Home invasions, serial killers, unfortunate accidents, and paranormal terror can all be found in these movies. Get Out. Jordan Peele's Get Out is an unflinching look at race in America. Photographer Chris and his girlfriend Rose have traveled to her family's estate in upstate New York. Chris thinks he is Rose's first black boyfriend, but he is dreadfully wrong. The Armitage family are actually serial killers who transplant the brains of aging white folks into the bodies of the young, healthy black people they kidnap.
Hands up to your damn stomach.
You got her.
I'm gonna quit.
She'd take it.
The Babadook. In Jennifer Kent's The Babadook, the monster seems to be a figure from a mysterious children's book found by Samuel, a young boy being brought up by his widowed mother, Emilia. But the actual villain of The Babadook is grief. Emilia and Samuel's pain at the tragic and unexpected loss of their husband and father has curdled into something utterly devastating, something they need to face head-on before it destroys them both. Candyman. After being tortured, mutilated, and lynched for the crime of falling in love with a white woman, Daniel Robitaille returns as the ghostly killer Candyman, whose terrifying presence is invoked by saying his name 5 times while looking in a mirror. His signature phrase, "Be my victim," is accompanied by swarms of bees that erupt from his body. He has a hook jammed into the raw flesh of his wrist. He is grisly, unique, and altogether unforgettable.
1919. Poor Candyman.
One knows he isn't real.
Contagion. Even before pandemic was the order of the day, Steven Soderbergh's Contagion was one of the scariest movies of all time. Told in Soderbergh's classic ensemble style, the movie follows a number of key players as a virus spreads across the globe. What started its rampage? A bit of infected pork prepared by a chef who didn't wash his hands. Cue global collapse.
I got people too.
Get back in your car!
We're not sick!
Geralt's Game. Mike Flanagan's adaptation of Geralt's Game, once considered Stephen King's most unfilmable novel, has multiple levels of fear going on at once. Jesse Burlingame's husband Geralt dies atop her in a remote cabin, leaving her handcuffed to the bed. The front door is open, allowing a dog to get in and begin eating Geralt's corpse. Things go from bad to worse as Jesse relives childhood sexual abuse and begins to suffer the effects of dehydration. Then, a monstrous man begins visiting her at night, who turns out not to be a hallucination as Jessie will herself to believe.
It's time to wake up.
7. David Fincher's neo-noir crime horror 7 may have been memed to death, "What's in the box?" But that does not make the film even a little less scary. Following detectives Mills and Somers during Somers' last week of work, the partners investigate a serial killer who is using the 7 deadly sins as his guidebook. Fincher's chilly aesthetic understates the horror of each murder, which actually make them scarier. A world in which these grotesque deaths are treated as normal is a frightening prospect. The Conjuring. As The Conjuring has spawned an entire Conjuring universe of movies, it's easy to forget how bone-chilling scary the first installment is. Introducing paranormal investigators Ed and Lauren Warren as they investigate a possible poltergeist as Rhode Island home, The Conjuring masterfully balances short-term scares with slow-burn narrative energy. Seriously, only a movie at the top of its game could weave together possessed dolls, secret passages, and centuries-old curses into a coherently terrifying ending.
Sitting here with Carolyn Perrin, who...
What is it?
The Ring. Both the original Japanese horror film Ring and its American remake The Ring are top contenders for scariest movies of all time. While Ring may be more understandable when it comes to imagery and production, The Ring doesn't ever follow over the top. there are two varieties on a great story, both of which will scare you beyond your limits. The Shining. Stanley Kubrick's cinematic adaptation of Stephen King's novel The Shining might not be the most faithful adaptation of the book, but it is one of the scariest films of all time. Set in the remote Overlook Hotel during the height of a Rocky Mountains winter, the isolation of setting is terrifying on its own. But when you throw malignant ghosts, alcoholism, and the madness of writer's block into the mix, well, the stakes don't get much higher than that. The Shining is a world of terrifying imagery, strange behavior, and family drama that builds to one of the most unforgettable climaxes in horror history.
What happened with me?
The Thing. It's one thing to be isolated in Antarctica during a blizzard. It's another thing entirely to be isolated along with a shape-shifting alien entity that you and your crew accidentally dig up. It's worse still when said alien turns out to be capable of mimicking humans perfectly, making it impossible to know who to trust. Glimpsed through the eyes of helicopter pilot Mac Ready as he and his crew try to untangle the alien being John Carpenter's The Thing is a work of ununiquely potent psychological horror.
Inside, we know or feel it.
I know I'm here.
Which one is your favorite among all? Do share in the comments section. Thank you so much.